Hello there and happy Video Monday. Tisha Mahar here with you. And welcome to my apartment. And big favor, guys, I'm going to have to ask you to bear with me on this one because I have a serious travel hangover. So if I'm a little bit, slurring or not quite getting things across super clearly, I apologize. I've been running on not enough sleep, and I've been to like 4 different countries in like a week, and it's been all quite crazy. And I think that's actually a really good topic for a video. How to manage all of those nasty symptoms that come with being on too many airplanes, like dehydration and lack of circulation and blood flow and dry skin and the list goes on. Anyway, let's set that aside. This video, big shout out to Dimity. She requested this topic. And today's topic, this week's Video Monday topic, is inflammation as well as joint and muscle pain. So, as with all things, there's a number of different causes for inflammation and for joint muscle pain. It is hard to say why you might be experiencing this if you are. And with all of the topics that I explore, this is why I've been referencing the need for us all to really do the detective work with these things. You can't give up. You gotta like be a warrior about it and just keep trying to get to the root as opposed to using a band-aid. Don't just take a bunch of, you know, anti-inflammatories or different pills or whatever. Like sometimes, yes, some of that stuff can be helpful for managing symptoms when you need it, when you really need it. And also like, you know, topical creams and things like this can be fabulous, but you really want to figure out why. When did this start? What could be causing it? What was different in my life when this wasn't happening? All of these things you really need to, you know, dig away at, and I encourage you to do that work. And if you need help, that's why it's good to work with someone like me or a different nutritionist that you trust to really help you get to the root of your health problem. Because the body is really self-healing if it's given the proper tools and love and respect. Okay. Inflammation, joint, and muscle pain. So let's first look at what could be causing that. What are the main things that come to my mind if a client comes to me with this? Number one, I think, okay, are there any dietary contributors to this problem? So especially if this is a new thing that kind of seemed to like show up out of nowhere, I like to look to that. Some of the main things that can contribute to inflammation in the diet are, I would say, sugar, processed foods for sure, and refined grains. So number one, if you have an inflammatory condition or you have pain in your body, muscle, joint pain, if you eat those three things, start there. Cut out all the processed foods. So transition yourself to a 100% whole foods-based diet. Start with that. It might not be enough, unfortunately, but start there because sometimes it is. So cut out the alcohol, cut out the processed foods, and see where you are at, okay? So that's the first step. There's other things that could be contributing to this. Some people react in terms of inflammation specifically to grains. Some people are really not tolerant to grains. Their body just can't handle it. Especially I see this in women after the age of 35, 40s, 50s, even younger sometimes. And sometimes it can be anybody, but grains can be a problem. Okay, so that is something to consider. They might not be a problem, but especially what I'm referring to here is gluten. So cut out all of the gluten first, and then you may even need to cut out things like, you know, rice or gluten-free oatmeal or quinoa, the pseudo grains. those foods are wonderful and healthful, but they might not be right for you. So if you have an inflammatory condition and you're already eating a whole foods-based diet, my next recommendation for you would be to cut out all sources of gluten and maybe even grains. Beyond that, there may be the need to look at an autoimmune protocol. So this is called the AIP protocol, and there are various ones, mostly created by the paleo community. They've done some really good work in terms of this, and the autoimmune protocol takes what I've mentioned a few steps further and also includes the elimination of nightshades. So that's like potatoes, red pepper, tomatoes, eggplant. So those are the nightshade vegetables. Sometimes people are reacting to those. So if you also are pretty sure that you're good with grains, you might just try that. Get rid of nightshades, tomatoes, red peppers, eggplant, potato, cayenne pepper. So look up what a nightshade is and cut those out for like a week or so and see if the inflammation goes down. That's a good one. There's also more to the autoimmune protocol than what I've just mentioned, like cutting out legumes as well, and sometimes nuts and seeds. It can be a pretty extreme protocol. So you don't necessarily need to go there if you're just having some inflammation. The autoimmune protocol is actually designed for people who think they might have an autoimmune disease. That might not be you. But that said, the reason that they're eliminating those foods is for good reason, and it's because they can sometimes create inflammation for people. So look at those types of things. Beyond specifics in terms of food, if you have not changed a thing about your diet, you've always been eating the same diet, you're sure there's nothing that wasn't there before that's there now, etc. If you're sure of that, these are the next two things that I really want to mention about this topic. Number one, your fatty acid balance. So we need a certain degree of what's called essential fats. The essential fats are omega 3, 6, and 9. And often we're getting a lot of fats in the diet, people especially who are eating processed foods, from like bad fats like soybean oil and corn oil and cottonseed oil and all this crap, canola oil, terrible. So all of those oils can disrupt your balance of fatty acids, meaning you're getting more of the bad fats and not enough of those good fats. So where do you get good fats? Nuts, seeds, avocado, olive oil, wild caught fish, these types of things, chia seeds, the list goes on. But these are the types of good fats that we want in our diet. Even if you include animal products, you know, you can get good fats from, egg yolk and, again, fish is a good one. There's lots of sources, but you want to make sure that you're not doing those processed oils that you're going to find mostly in processed foods. And you're also going to have a lot of exposure to those oils when you're eating out at like Chinese food restaurants and stuff like that. So be careful of that. And in addition to that, I've had clients come to me who are like have been strict vegetarians and vegans for a long time and who are having issues with inflammation. And being a yogi and fine and really valuing that feeling of being able to move freely in your body as well as like flexibility, you can have a lot of inflammation in your body and feel really flexible and mobile. And so this is important to me. And so I always make sure that I'm getting more, specifically omega-3, than I am from 6 and 9, because you need more 3 to keep that balance right in that sweet spot. So vegetarians will get lots of, usually, omega-6 and omega-9 from their nuts and seeds and those things that I mentioned. But sometimes they're lagging behind in the omega-3. So where can you get omega-3 in the vegan diet? A few good places: chia seeds, flax seeds. You can get an algae oil, so a vegan-based omega-3 supplement. These would be really, really good ways to boost your intake. I always have taken a really good vegan omega-3 supplement. I've even at times brought in some krill oil, which obviously isn't vegan, I know, but I actually have found that it helped me. So if I've ever had an issue where I was feeling inflammation and I'm really tuned into my body because of my practice, and so I am aware of that, I've brought in the krill oil at times, a really good sourced one, and I find that that has helped with this. So make sure you're getting a good balance of healthy fats in your diet. You need omega-3, you need omega-6, you need omega-9, and just try to make sure you're really getting, for sure, above and beyond all else, those omega-3s. The third thing that I want to draw your attention to if you have inflammation or if you have muscle and joint pain is a hormone imbalance. So I often see that when people are having issues with their adrenals and or their thyroid, because often when your thyroid takes a hit, it takes your adrenals out and vice versa. Who knows which one is going first? I would say adrenals usually. When the adrenals go down, then the thyroid goes down too. So these two systems really work together. And so if you are having issues with your hormones, like your sex hormones, if you're constantly tired, if you are feeling anxious all the time, if you are having severe PMS, I also would encourage you to look to those things that I mentioned about the diet, because it could be both things happening. But if you are having issues with muscle joint pain inflammation and you also are having hormone imbalances, that needs to be addressed too. And of course, we would never address any hormone issue without also looking to the diet. So this is where it really takes a holistic approach. But just be aware of that. You might want to invest in some testing. So get your thyroid tested. And please, you guys, this is a whole separate video and I will do this. If you are getting your thyroid tested, don't just get your TSH tested, especially if you're having some kind of crazy hormone stuff going on. The TSH does not give a full view of what's going on in terms of the health of your thyroid. There's more tests you need, and usually doctors are not willing to run these, and because of that, you need to go one step further often and ask and pay for a specific number of tests. These are, get a pen and paper, you want to go get your TSH measured, your T3, your free T3, your free T4, your reverse T3, and what's called TPO antibodies. Those are the five really important thyroid markers you need to know. TSH, free T3, free T4, reverse T3, TPO, thyroid antibodies. The final one I mentioned, the TPO antibodies, really important for detecting a possible thyroid autoimmune disease called Hashimoto's. So critical. So if you're having crazy hormone things going on, plus a ton of muscle joint pain, it would be good to rule that out, for sure. And I've had clients who I had run those tests, and they came back without the without Hashimoto's, but they did still have their thyroid was off, and they were explaining that they had inflammation and these types of things. And so we needed to work holistically on treating the hormone imbalance and the adrenals, but also looking at the foods that might be exacerbating the symptoms. So that's a lot. In terms of the adrenals, Adrenals are often run down in most people, and I've done lots of videos on adrenal fatigue, so you can look for those on my channel if you want to hear more about my views on dealing with this. But just know that if your thyroid is out, you need to love your adrenals up as well. So again, these systems work together. You can't address one without addressing the other. So as always, you guys, I hope this has been helpful. Please send your messages. Please continue to send your requests, because your topics are amazing. And you can guarantee that if there's something that you're struggling with, you're not alone. There's probably 15 other people who are having those 15 other people. That was crazy of me to say. 15, maybe million other people who are... I apologized at the beginning of this, who are also struggling with that. So you're not alone at all. And so please know that. And there is an answer to why you are feeling the way that you feel. The body doesn't just go out of balance for no reason. The body doesn't get sick and break down for no reason. So you have to look at what is going on beneath the surface. And of course, I hope this goes without saying, that also extends to lifestyle factors and emotional stuff and mental patterns and behaviors. You gotta look at the whole picture. And I always encourage my clients to think back on a time when what they're now experiencing wasn't happening. Because there's often clues there. Okay, when I felt my best, what was different in my life? Maybe you were in a job that you loved, that you really loved and felt fulfilled in. Maybe you were in a really supportive relationship. Maybe you weren't eating a certain food group and now, I am again. Or something like that. Really think back, because you are your best teacher. Other people's experiences and advice can only go so far. You need to learn you, and you need to do you, and you need to create a diet that is perfect and right for you. I love you guys. Send your messages, send your requests, and have a really, really beautiful week. Bye.